Hello guys, it's me again, Rose from the Philippines. It's October 11, it's a Wednesday, and I just wanted to catch up with you guys for another podcast because I haven't been making videos lately. I just have a few items that I can show you. We have been busy taking care of the kids since my ate is still working on her new job. And my kuya is also, my brother-in-law is also busy with stuff, so we are helping him in fetching the kids from school. So I have been doing that, and Daniel is asleep right now, so I had a chance to make a podcast. And I wanted to show you this one finished project that I have, and I have been using it for a while now. It is this Tunisian crochet bag. This part is all Tunisian crochet, and I have a wrap pattern for this and turned out like this. It is a butterfly. The back part is consists of half double crochets, and for the side parts I connected them with single crochet, and it's a box type of bag. Like the Space Invaders bag that I made, but this one is much more bigger. As you can see, it's very thick, and since it is a box type, I also crocheted this part, and then I put a zipper and lining in it. And this strap or this handle is about 50 treble crochet long. So that is my finished object that I wanted to show you guys. And I haven't been making some tutorials yet. I was hoping to make one with a hexagonal design wallet, but I haven't still made another example for it. So that will be my next bead tutorial. Thank you to my new subscribers. I'm hoping that you have been making the beads wallet ever since I have put it there for you guys. So recently, we have also been playing with some paper crafts. So we have made some like this, with someone waving at the window part of it. So this is what we have been up to, the kids and I. We have been making some paper crafts, and I also have been making some cards using doodle design. But I think Nicole wouldn't agree with me that this is doodle, because she said that this is drawing. So I purchased some carton papers or vellum board papers, and I have been doodling in it using the Staedtler color pencils that Miss Grace gave me. So I made this one, and I really enjoyed making this one. I have a reference for it, the coloring book that she sent me. And then the other day I made this one. So as you can see, I don't know if it is called doodle art, because Nicole, she said that this is drawing. So I have just been accumulating that, and since I have the vellum board, I have also been making some calling cards. And there is an event at October 15. It's a yarn caravan. It's an event wherein crocheters from the Philippines or within the Metro Manila gathers, and they just talk about crochet. So I wanted to come, and it is free registration. So that will be on Sunday. I wouldn't be able to go to church, and I have already said that to my tita. I wanted to go there to meet other crocheters from the Philippines, because the crocheters that goes there has this group on Facebook called Ganchillo Filipino Filipino Association. So I wanted to meet some guys there or maybe purchase some cool yarns. And it is in Luneta, so it is easily accessible to get there. So pretty excited about that because that is going to be on October 15. And just a while ago, I have watched at Miss Karen's podcast about the World Health Day or month. So she has told some stories about her experience with her mental health or her mental disability, and I have also been diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, so in a way I can relate to her, but I don't know if I can tell you why I had the sickness, but I also have been suffering with that type of kinds. Sorry if I have been rambling, but I have made also some small projects. Like this one, this was supposed to be a coin purse, but I turned it into a cell holder. But this is using the basket weave stitch. But what's missing is the handle, so I don't have enough yarn for that, so I'm going to incorporate another color of yarn for this. And I also started this one, and there's also nothing, there's also no more of it, so I'm going to continue this using another yarn. And this is where I put the calling cards that I have been making because it suits here. And I also have this other wallet wherein I put some more of that calling cards that I have drawn into. It has I've written some stuff there about my account names in Facebook, stuff like that. So this is going to be useful for the yarn caravan I'm going to go to on Sunday. Just to meet you guys with the same passion. The other day, I started some Tunisian crochet with this design, but it is kind of an epic fail because it has some problems with tension. I think I'm supposed to use a Tunisian crochet hook one size lower than this one, because the one that I use for this is a number 4 millimeter, so I think I was supposed to use a 3 millimeter. And also the problem with this is that maybe it's because of the thickness of the yarns, they vary, so the thinnest of them is the yellow and some are also thin while the others are in the thicker side. So it became like this. And I'm thinking that I can make it into a cell holder of some type. So I just want to experiment more in this. And I have other graph designs that I want to try out. So this is going to be still in the works. And also, since I have made the monokini, I have delivered it for my cousin. And Kuya JP, she requested for me to make him or Ate Rina a monokini. So I started on that one. And I am lacking the yarn or the thread. So I need to buy more of this cotton mercerized yarn or thread. And I also have, I have some foam leftovers from before. So I don't need to buy more of this. And just a while ago, my sister-in-law Ate May, she asked me to make her a pouch for her hair iron for her hair. So I need to make a covering for this, just like a tumbler holder. So it's going to be like this, but I'm going to use a black yarn. It needs to be much more taller. So, and then it's going to be a drawstring type with some handles on it. So, I am starting it right now using this Familia black yarn. So, I already started it and I am this far from it. It has become like this. And I also incorporated some camel stitch so it will have, it wouldn't be bland looking. So this is going to be a very long project to make for today. I'm hoping that I will finish it today so I can give it to her. And I also have an update for the hat that I've been making. For this project, I'm dotting it because I don't know how tall it should be before the decrease. Although I asked Miss Juliet and she said that she made her hat 10 inches long before the decrease, but the one that she did, it is the bottom part can be folded. But for this one, I'm going to turn this into some type of regular guy beanie. So still doubting it, and I'm quite apprehensive about the crown part because I need to transfer this to another needle, not a circular one. So the last days that has passed by, I have been watching some series on YouTube, like the medical investigation series, but I have watched most of it, so I turned to another series on YouTube that is called Travelers. So I have been watching that, but I wasn't able to recently because Sophie is using my cell phone. So I'm going to watch that soon. And Sophie's field trip is done now. It is from Friday. We went to Intramuros and we went to watch a 3D movie and then to Dreamplay. And I have a video of that so you can see. And thinking that I will cut this now because it has gone to 12 minutes. So I just wanna catch up with you guys and hope that you are all doing well and happy crafting. It is sunny here today. And so Mama has been, she washed the clothes yesterday and now she's drying them up. So it helps that the weather is sunny today. So I hope you guys have a fun day and some family bonding time with your kids or your parents. And that's it for me. Bye for now.